Hello, everyone. My name is Marina Schoenemann. I'm the Business Development Manager in Disruptive, a medtech company based in Sweden and Spain.
Hello, my name is Björn Jürgens. I'm patent analyst at Agencia Innovación en Desarrollo of Andalucía and a CIPIA PatLab Center, also located in southern Spain.
We've been here invited to tell you about our experience. We've both worked together on the patent search based on a request we did to Agencia IDEA regarding our IP strategy. Okay, so Disruptive is a medical technology company mainly, starting in Sweden, and we're also here in Spain now. And we've created the first platform for implantable chips in the world. It's a company focused on R&D, but our IP strategy is lacking. We've started developing and presenting the product before patenting it, mainly because we're a startup, lack of personnel, and that's why we contacted Agencia IDEA. This is our product, the one we've contacted the agency about. Our platform for implantable chips is based on a passive subdermal implant that has no batteries and contains an NFC antenna that allows it to connect via mobile phone to the cloud, and digital sensors that allow to do readings inside the body. This is what we wanted to patent and what we presented in our request to the agency. You can see the video of our temperature implant being used, which monitors body temperature long-term and presents information to the user, not only about the data, but trends and more added value. So this was our main issue. We had checked our freedom to operate. We weren't infringing any other patents, but we didn't have one ourselves. We wanted to do some IP protection. We didn't know where to start exactly. So we consulted IDEA, requesting this report, not only to check if our invention was patentable, but what other things existed in the market that was similar to it. We asked for this report, and then we met with them to review it, and we did this follow-up to check how to improve our IP strategy, which is very important for startups and companies in the tech industry.
Thanks, Marina. I'm taking over now. My name is Björn Jürgens. I'm from the CIPIA PatLab Center. We are IPO PatLab Center in Granada, and also in Seville and all the other capitals of Andalusia. And as a PatLab Center, we have the typical portfolio of a PatLab Center. We have the help desk. We offer search services, and we offer filing services via the Patent National Office. And with the SME, with the Disruptive, they came to us. We decided to opt for a search report. In order to help them out, to look at their similar technologies around which can affect their business. So what we did for our search service, what we used as our search tool was, in this case, Global Patent Index. It is EPO's expert patent search tool containing worldwide patent data, not only DocDB, but also INPADOC, legal status events, and full text provided by national offices. It has a similar coverage than as PassNet, but we are using GPI for the reasons here mentioned here, because it's, first of all, it offers really complex search queries, doesn't have the limitation of keywords. The search steps can be combined. The interface is customizable. It's really, really nice feature. We can search legal status, quite important for also freedom to operate searches. And we can export the data sets, and it's personalized as it is a user-based, login-based tool. And most important for PatLab centers, as we were, the EPO offers a free license for the PatLabs. So coming to the search, Our search strategy we used for the project with Disruptive. Here you see the search query. It's quite a straightforward search. We had three concepts here in this search. We had the implantable or subcutaneous concept. Then we had a sensor monitoring concept. And then we had, which was quite crucial for the technology Disruptive, it had to have the NFC, the near field communication technology for communicating the signals of this implantable device. Furthermore, we also used a class. In this case, we found a CPC, which was quite relevant, as the technology of Disruptive was very, very new. We didn't use a priority date restriction in this case. And then by using GPI, here I'll show you the result list. You see some of the interesting features of GPI that you can configure the layout of the database. Here we configured the result list. So we had in this case the priority date also in the list. And there we see already one document which was found to be quite interesting. It is a Danish document, Danish patent application, which more or less described a similar technology than was the case for Disruptive. But as we see here, the priority is very new. So it wasn't a document that could affect the business of Disruptive. Would be more the opposite, that Disruptive could hinder this patent to go on its way. The thing is that we did checked the other week, and this patent was not accepted at all. So it was it lacked of claims in this case. So this was probably a patent from patent trolls, we're guessing. But still, it was quite an interesting thing to see that this patent application, Danish patent application, had some very similar technology to the one from Disruptive. So what we did for the report here is we used the export feature of GPI. That's also something new here. It's the ODT export feature, which is really useful if you want to export more than one document. In this case, we had about 20 relevant documents, not crucial, but at least they were interesting for Disruptive to see what was there around in the market. And we used the ODT export, which is an export for compatible to OpenOffice, also the MS Office format, where you can export when you have this concatenated feature, you can export all the documents in a row. This is really useful if you're a PadLab center and offer reports, as we do, makes work quite easier. It looks like that, the generated file. Interesting feature also, it looks that includes your legal status of each document. Very interesting for freedom of operator reports. And then at the end, we converted it to a formatted document. You see the first two pages of this of our reports, and this was handed over to the company. And then on a follow-up, what we did is we did a conference call and talked it through the results and commented on especially this Danish document we found. As a follow-up in general, what I also would like to point out is what we're doing now is monitoring this technology. We're using here in this case the so-called DFE operator of GPI, which is basically the meaning the date of first exchange. Where you can search the documents that were first included in GPI. So this is quite useful for doing ongoing monitoring. We have this, in this example, you see we use a search query we already did for the report. We can, on a time frame we decide, we can do some monitoring. On this example here, we did a monitoring for the month of between July and September. And we did this monitoring early October. We found in this case two new documents. So it's a quite, I think it's an interesting feature of, of GPI, which not many users maybe know already, but it's especially if you're doing monitoring services for the company, I think I would recommend it. Yeah, and that's it for us. Here we have our contact details. Feel free to reach out to us if you have any doubts, and we also here for answering now any questions that may arise. Thanks a lot.